Hello, viewers all over the world. We are coming to you with 101 today, and we want to discuss on the International Decade for People of African Descent. So from 2015 to 2024. In our studio, this hour is an intellectual who is here to throw a little bit of light to what this whole thing is all about, because there have been too much of emails going via, and then people are talking too much about this international decade of people of African descent, and we want the grassroots to also know what this whole thing is all about. So join me as we welcome our guest today, who is no other person but someone who have studied cultural anthropology, and he was the ex-director of 9C, which is National Institute of Dutch Slavery Past and Heritage, and currently he is working at the Institute of Cultural Heritage and Knowledge. This person is no other one but our own Dr. Atwell Kane. Doctor, please welcome
to
Majesty Christian Television Network.
Thank you for inviting me.
Right.
Thank you.
We are glad to have you too. Okay. So we want to, we would like you to throw more light on what this international decade of people of African descent is all about. Mm-hmm. And then you are going to use very simple language so that the grassroots can understand you. Is that okay?
Good, sure.
Right,
sure.
So
I'll do my best.
Yes. So welcome to the program once again. And please, would you be very clear to tell us what this whole international decade of people of African descent is all about?
Well, actually, it started in Durban, South Africa, in 2001.
South Africa?
Yeah, in South Africa, when they had this, because the UN had a conference on racism, and that was in 2001 in Cape Town, Durban, and in that conference there were these African descent groups who were pushing to do something against racism, to do something about the plight of people of African descent internationally.
Yeah.
Right? Because, I mean, everywhere you go, you see that black people, most of the time, are at the bottom of the list.
Yes.
And this is something that has started, let's say, from the 16th century.
Okay.
But anyway, back to today. So what happened is that in the United Nations, they had this resolution to have a 10-year period where emphasis is placed and recognition of people of African descent internationally, but also equality for people of African descent, and also the development of people of African descent.
Right.
So therefore, they asked their member countries to prepare a program of action to deal with these 3 points. Right.
Okay.
So what happened is that the national platform of slavery pass.
Uh-huh.
With as representative, Dr. Beryl
Bickman,
has been having these discussions with the Ministry of Social Affairs and Labour in The Hague on behalf of the Dutch government.
Okay.
And so therefore, so the government needs to have information to write her own national plan in the framework of this 10 years of for people of African descent.
Okay, wait a minute. Mm-hmm. So this 10 years for people of African descent is not only for the Dutch, it's not only for the Netherlands. Is it for every country where people of African descent are living? Is that what you're saying?
Definitely, because it's also for Nigeria, for Ghana, for South Africa, for Jamaica, for Trinidad, for United States of America, for Canada, everywhere, because it's an international thing.
Yeah, okay.
So, but then we're dealing with the Netherlands, because we're living in the Netherlands.
Okay.
So it means that everyone of African descent, whether you're from Cameroon or Nigeria or Ghana
or
Suriname,
Trinidad or Suriname,
you're part of the African descent.
Yes.
So you have African descent from the continent Africa.
Yeah.
And you have African descent from Trinidad, United States, Holland, England, France, etc., etc.
Yeah.
But then this program that we are working on is the program of the Dutch government for the people who are living here and also in the Caribbean, in Suriname.
All right. So you said that UN reminded you this is a UN project.
It's a UN project, yeah.
Okay. So if UN did not remind these people, they wouldn't have known could do something for the African descent who are in their land.
I don't think so. I think this is actually this is an initiative that has been taken by the VN, mm-hmm. by the United Nations. Sorry, mm-hmm. but then it's an initiative that was pushed by groups.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Activists of African people of African descent.
Okay.
Also supported by the African Union.
Okay. So that is to say that all the heads of states. They are aware of it.
Oh, sure. They are aware of it also. Definitely.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, they are aware of it.
Okay. Yeah. So what are this? What are the Dutch government, what are they supposed to do for these people of African descent here in the Netherlands?
Well, like I said a bit earlier on, they have to make sure that the people of African descent who mm-hmm. are living here have this sense of, okay, we have been seen. Oh. We have been recognized.
Okay.
All right? We are human beings also. Right?
Okay.
And you shouldn't even be saying that we're human beings also, because you're a human being. Whatever happens, you're a person.
It's true.
Right?
Yeah.
So you shouldn't even be paying any emphasis to that, but then that's part of it. It also has to do with development and the different fields, whether it's education, employment, healthcare, et cetera. All the different fields where people have to be developed.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And kids especially.
Okay.
And at the same time, equality.
Equality, wow.
Right?
That's good, yes.
So we're not only going to speak about these things, we're going to make sure that these things happen. Actually, not we only, but also the governments. And in this case, the Dutch government.
Okay. Right? When you talk about development, so are we saying that in terms of maybe school, mm-hmm. are we saying that the Dutch people have to go to our own country to go and develop our school system or what?
No, they will develop their school system here. They will develop
To accommodate us. Yeah. Oh, so that means like here, the language is mostly the barrier for many of us.
Right.
So no matter how you have grown in this culture, they still want you to believe that you are not integrated enough.
Because your language isn't good enough. Well, and that's one of the things that's happening here, because now we have this form that has to be filled in.
Okay.
Where people can find at www.people/line/of/african-descent/.nl.
Okay.
When all these organizations fill in this form that's on the website.
Okay.
And also say what their organization do. Also say what they do as individual mm-hmm. persons who have certain expertise, mm-hmm. then programs will have to be made. Programs dealing with that these organizations
yes.
can take part in, and also when they need someone who has certain expertise,
yes.
they will know that this person could be found at organization X or Y, or they're looking for a very good preacher, for instance, and then they know they have to come to
me.
To you.
as a majesty
organization, because you are filling the form.
Okay.
And then, okay, so we need a good preacher, so we go to, and we need someone who, and not only preacher, but then someone who is good at empowerment.
Yeah,
giving
okay.
people, to empower people.
Okay.
To get to talk to people.
Yeah.
To bring them on the right track.
Okay.
So this is part of the whole thing, is to use the talent that we have within the Dutch community.
Yes.
So then you can look at it in three ways. One way is that the government gets this, what we call the social card.
Social card.
Yeah, the social card is actually done, which are the organizations of African descent in the Netherlands, whether they're dealing with remittance, or dealing with slavery, or dealing with anti-racism, or whatever they're dealing with, or religious affairs, or whatever.
Yes.
And which are the individuals who have certain expertise in certain fields.
Okay.
And then programs will have to be made about how to deal with all these things that these people are saying, this is what we want, this is what we think should be done in the coming 10 years for people for and with, and that's very important, for and with people of African descent.
Yes.
So it's not like they're going to do things for us. Mm-mm. They're doing things together with us. So yeah. There's this for and with us.
Okay. Oh, that's very, very good.
Yeah.
For and with us.
Yeah, right.
Also, they are not going to allow us to just run it all by ourselves.
No. But at the same time...
We are working alongside with them.
Yeah, right. And it shouldn't be either that they're doing it for us also. That they say, okay, you people want that and we're going to do it for you. No, it's going to be something together.
Together.
Yeah, we work in cooperation. Together. Yeah.
Oh,
in cooperation, wow. Yeah.
Does that mean, does that suggest that they've been doing things all for themselves or doing it all apart without getting us involved?
Well, mostly it's gone like that. And you have to realize that these European societies were not built for us, for people of African descent.
Mm-hmm.
We are still guests. Even our kids who were born here, mm-hmm. they are guests in these countries. In that sense, that's how they feel.
Yes, it's true.
In actual fact, legally, they are Dutch.
Yeah.
And they have a Dutch passport. But in terms of how they feel, they don't really feel Dutch because they're not treated as being part of the Dutch society. And those who were immigrants and who came to this country, they have this double feeling.
Yeah.
When am I Dutch? When am I not?
Exactly. Because I think it has to also do with even when you have become nationalized, you know, they still will be asking you your state of origin, your place of birth.
Right.
You see? I think maybe things like that have to be scrapped off if really we have really been, integrated, is that? Or accepted in the society.
Yeah, definitely. Because this is actually what we're talking about, a sense of belonging.
Yeah.
And not a sense of displacement.
Yeah, exactly.
Because if you're going to continue to live in a sense of displacement, then you're not functioning the way you should function. You're not using your talent like what you were saying. You're not living in a magnificent way.
Yeah.
In a useful way.
Yeah.
Because you have to have this sense of belonging.
Exactly.
To really give 100%. Right.
Before you relax to bring out your best.
Right.
So where are we now in this whole project? I'm excited.
Who's we?
The people who are pushing this forward, you know?
Well, it's just...
Like in Mevra Bikman of you. You've done some research on this, isn't it?
Yeah, right. Yeah,
so tell us a little bit of your finding.
Well, we're just starting because Dr. Bikman has done the negotiations with the ministry and with the government. It's now done the bringing in of the other black organizations, people of African descent, organizations and individuals to take part in this process. So this whole thing has to be set up.
Okay.
Because the government has to write its own action plan.
Okay.
And we have to make sure that we are part of that plan. So we have to, as it is, if the fire has to be started, we have to bring the wood. Right? We have to bring the wood and we have to bring the matches and the oil to start this fire and to keep this fire burning.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
Yeah, so how far are you people getting the real Africans, the Africans, I don't know how to put it now.
Yeah.
Those who
African
have...
African the continent.
Yes. How far are you people getting the Africans who are here connected to this whole thing?
Well... Some are connected because...
Because you are saying people of African descent, people of African... How far are you getting the Nigerians, the Ghanaians, the Cameroonians, the Liberians, the Togolese? How far are you getting them connected? The Burundis, the Rwandas? How are you getting them connected to this whole movement?
That's a very good question because I think LPS, Mrs. Bigman, she has a list of how many persons from the different countries are here in the Netherlands. And so, as you know, she's worked on this 6-region thing. And there was a conference, I think like 3 or 4 weeks ago in The Hague at the Belier Hotel, where there were different representatives of the different African countries.
Uh-huh.
And the idea is, and then there's this an organization called, I forgot the name of the organization, which is an African-based organization here in the Netherlands, where I think it's like a foundation, a federation, where different continental African organizations are affiliated to.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think it's a LOA, I think.
I don't know.
Right?
But I was in the meeting.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Right? So what happens is that the idea is to get those organizations also involved.
Okay.
And then on all the other organizations from the people from the Suriname... Suriname background or culture, has set up an Antillean and so forth and so forth. So that is the idea. And, well, we have to produce this report as soon as possible.
How soon?
Well, the government is saying the 15th of October. That's very soon. But in the process of doing the gathering the information, mm-hmm. right, doing mm-hmm. the empirical work, empirical, it means yeah. doing the real work yeah. in the field, I have noticed that there are a lot of organizations who want to get involved. But a lot of the organizations haven't filled in the form as yet. So we have
maybe
to push them.
Because they've
really
not understood what it is all about.
Okay, well, I hope that after this this talk with you, mm-hmm. that there is more sense of what it is, there's more knowledge, mm-hmm. and that everyone is running after we finish with this interview
yeah.
to their computer.
Yeah, to fill the form.
To fill in the form yes. and send the form to us, mm-hmm. to info at people of African descent.
So,
because we need the form,
yes,
because then we need to know where the organization are, what are these organizations,
yeah.
and what do they want, and what can they also contribute?
Yes, to the society.
To the society,
that is
and also
good.
To part of this decade of people of African descent.
Okay. So why did it have that name? Why did it have this name, International Decade of People of African Descent?
Well, I guess it would have been difficult to put another title to it because, you know, we speak about black and black is a term because one friend once told me, and he's a Ghanaian, if you say black in Ghana, someone would ask you, what are you speaking about? Because they don't speak in terms of black or white in Ghana.
Yeah.
They speak in terms of which tribe are you from?
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Or in Nigeria, same thing.
Yeah.
Right? Black in the United States, they say people of African Americans.
Yeah.
In Brazil, black means something else also.
No, why is it a decade? Why?
Well, the decade
because the Suriname community, you know,
yeah.
they have been in this land for a long time. Also
right.
the Antillians and the rest of them. So they've lived more than 10 years. So why a decade?
Oh, well, the decade, well, it wasn't done by the Dutch government. I mean, United Nations did it because they realized if they do 1 year, before you turn around twice, 1 year is finished.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you might even need a year to set all these plans up.
Okay.
And before you start to implement your plans,
yeah.
then the year is finished.
Okay.
But if you said 10 years, then you have 10 years to set up your plans.
Yes.
In different, and then
implement.
to implement,
okay.
to monitor,
yeah.
to evaluate,
yes.
and see what's working, what's not working.
Exactly.
To change and re-implement on all that, to learn. And I always say we have to learn to unlearn, to relearn. So in that process, you can learn to unlearn.
And to relearn.
To relearn. Right? Right? And then you need 10 years to do all that. Because if you're going to just do it in 1 year or 5 years.
Yeah, it wouldn't work at all.
It won't be enough.
Wow.
It won't be enough time to plan and to execute.
Okay, so the email you sent
mm-hmm.
was supposed to address the social card.
Yeah.
So it was. So what are we looking exactly in the card? What are we looking for?
We'll be looking for the names of the organizations.
Names.
Where they're situated. The websites if they have that.
Yeah.
What form do they have? Or their foundation? Or their society? What do they do? Do they have projects that deal with African descent here in the Netherlands, or in Africa, or in Suriname, or in Aruba or Curacao?
Yeah.
How are they funding? Do they use their own money?
Okay.
Do they get funding from the
yes.
government,
yeah.
or do they get funding from other sources? Do they make their own money by doing certain things to generate their own funds and do their projects?
Yeah.
So these are the things that we need to know.
Okay.
And also, what are their ideas, right? Are their vision of this 10 years for people of African descent.
All right. So who are eligible to fill these forms?
Every African descent organization in the Netherlands
okay.
is eligible. And every person who thinks, well, I'm an expert on certain things, I am I know about journalism, I know about preaching, I know about empowerment. I know about how to communicate with people from other countries.
Yeah.
So I know about diversity,
etc.,
yeah, etc.
Yeah.
These people
are eligible.
Are eligible to fill in this form, and then we will look at it, and then we put all of this into the social card. In actual fact, it should be something that when we are finished with the report, after we can publish a book, and then you can open the book, and you can say, okay, there you have Majesty TV, and this is what Majesty TV does.
Yeah.
So if you need somebody, like I said earlier on, who is very good at empowerment and preaching, then you can go to management, to Majesty TV.
Yes.
And et cetera, et cetera. And that's the whole idea.
Okay. So that means there will be a book, and then people can easily access that book, and then, you know, or be able to know what every organization
does. Right. So there's, like I said, So one thing, the government needs it to make her own social plan.
But, yes, right? But doctor, wait for a minute. Mm-hmm. So these organizations have to also be documented.
Well, it'd be good.
Well documented, is that?
Right, but then some organizations are not documented. We know that.
Okay.
But then if you haven't got it, if you're not documented, you're not documented. There isn't any law that says that your organization needs to be documented, right? Because previously, you had certain organization and you're writing at the Chamber of Commerce, right? But it's not a compulsion because there's certain organizations that are still in development.
Okay.
When you think your organization is developed enough to be written in as the Chamber of Commerce, then you do that. If you haven't got that, you haven't got that.
Okay.
Some organizations have a board of directors with a treasurer, a president, a secretary.
Yeah.
Some organization only have two people or one person, whatever.
Okay.
It is still an organization. It still works.
Okay.
It does work.
Okay.
So people shouldn't be holding back because they think, well, I haven't got an organization with five workers, with a big board, with the president and secretary and all. You don't need to. You're an organization, and you can show that you're an organization and you have your activities and you reach people or whatever. Mm-hmm. Then you are eligible.
Okay.
So we're not making a distinction from the very start to who is eligible and who is not.
Eligible, yes.
Everyone is welcome. If you have an organization, you can fill in the form
and
send the form to us via the computer.
Okay.
Or if you haven't got a computer, then you can ask a friend to print the forms for you. Mm-hmm. You fill in the forms and you send it to us.
So what is the benefit of all of this to the grassroots? Or African descent that is here?
Well, there are diverse benefits. To start with, in terms of anti-racism, they can benefit from that because none of us want to be discriminated against. None of us want to feel that we are non-beings.
Exactly.
None of us want to feel that we do not count. And that's why the whole thing with recognition, we know that we are people and we have agency. Agency means we have a voice.
Yeah, exactly.
So you're not going to remain voiceless because this means that you are coming out of the zone of non-being and voicelessness, right?
Yes.
So you can
you
find
have a voice.
You have a voice. You can find your voice, right?
Yes.
But it also means also that as in terms of labor, let me know. If you need people for certain jobs, how to find them. And then there's always to this network.
Okay.
Because then these organizations can network with other organizations. And we say sometimes two heads are better than one.
Yes, it's true.
So you can cooperate with other organizations to build projects, to build activities, to build programs, whatever.
Yes.
So in that sense, the African descent communities are definitely going to profit from this whole process.
Yes.
He said, I don't see in any way that the African descent communities are not going to profit from the whole thing, especially if the government does what the government is supposed to do.
Okay. Wow. So when are we going to know if the government have done what they're supposed to do?
Well, there's another organization called CADA who just did a report on the government record of anti-racism and anti-discrimination, and this report was very damaging for the image of the Dutch government. And this report comes out every 5 years. And this last one was like 2 months ago. So next 5 years, and this organization reports to the United Nations organization.
Well, what are they called?
CERD. I can't remember from my head right now.
CERD.
Yeah, CERD. S-C-E-A-C. That is C-E-R-D.
Like so? C as in...
No. C as in...
As in Simon?
Carmen, yeah.
Yeah, no. Carmen.
Carmen.
Yes.
E as in Edward.
Oh, okay.
And R as in Richard.
Yeah.
And D as in Desmond.
Oh, okay.
So you can look it up and see.
Yes,
yeah.
I will.
Yeah, right.
I will.
And yeah. So they wrote this report and then they sent it to the United Nations and it wasn't very... It wasn't very nice for the Dutch government what was said in that report.
Wow.
Right? And they demanded that the Dutch government do a lot of things.
Yes.
And in terms of anti-racism, in terms of the getting rid of this Zwarte Piet.
Yeah, exactly.
Black Piet.
Yeah.
And all that. But then the next 5 years, another report will be produced. And they will say, okay, well, we did this in 2015.
Yeah.
And now we have this report. And even though you did an action plan in terms of the 10 years
yeah.
of people of African descent, we notice, and that's a good news thing, that you have done a lot.
Yeah, okay.
Because all these things have been developed. I'm just looking at it from the positive way.
Yeah.
If the Dutch government doesn't do anything, then they're going to come out and say, well, we warned you
yeah.
in 2015. It is now 2020.
Yeah.
And we noticed that you didn't do a thing.
Okay.
What's happening?
Yeah.
How come?
Yeah.
What is the problem? So my thing is, my hope is that the Dutch government really does something. So then in the next 5 years, in 2020,
yes.
then the people can say, oh, well, this is good.
Yes.
What you did is very good. Because
so that, yes, so then that means that the cooperation of all the organizations from the African descent is highly needed.
Definitely needed. Okay.
It's
fundamental to this thing.
Yeah,
fundamental.
They delay and they don't forward... they don't fill the inventory, the card, then you have nothing to work with.
And then you have nothing to complain about either, because the government can say, okay, we gave you the chance to say what you wanted to say and what you think you can contribute on what your program is and what your vision is,
yes.
but you didn't participate.
Wow.
So therefore, the government can use that in the next 5 years. Well, the people of African descent weren't really interested. They didn't fill in the forms, and they didn't do anything. So
exactly.
So we couldn't do anything because we didn't know.
This is serious.
We didn't have any information to do something for and with these people because they never really filled in their
forms.
The forms.
Wow. So would you please look into the camera and before we sign off and tell our viewers what is expected of them after this interview?
Well, it is very essential. It's even fundamental that they go to the website, which is people/African/descent, and then this is DESCENT, .NL.
.NL.
Yeah.
It's helpful,
okay? Yeah. And then you look... And then you'll find the form there and fill it in. And it doesn't make any difference whether you fill it in Dutch or in English because we can do both languages.
Okay.
So whether you fill it in Dutch or in English, we get it and we will work on that to make the social
card. Yes. So in case you are listening to this broadcast and maybe you did not hear or you don't know how to access the card, you can as well call us right now. On 0233-74160, and then Dr.
Atwell
can clarify on this topic. Or you may forward your email to us. I think we have the distance, then we can also forward to them.
Right, and they can also call me.
They can call you on which number?
Tomorrow. 06-23-23-7967. So if they're having difficulties with the questions, or translating the questions, whatever.
Yes.
They can call me and I will help. I'm always willing to help because we definitely need this information.
Yes, exactly.
Because it shouldn't be that someone is going to say later, well, we asked them and they never did anything.
Yeah.
So therefore, they were not interested.
Yeah. So finally, students, are they allowed to fill the form too?
If they have an organization.
Oh, okay.
Or if they have, and if they have, yeah, organization especially. Okay. But then people who, we call it, people who have special talents or special expertise,
yeah,
are allowed to fill them in also.
They can fill in.
Yeah.
Okay. So then, is there any other information you want us to know before we sign up?
No, that's what it is. I want to thank you for having me here.
Thank you.
And thank you for giving us the opportunity to reach the people.
Right.
Because we definitely need the support of the people, because supporting us is supporting yourself.
Yes, exactly. It's true. So if you have listened to this broadcast and you are somebody that is from the African descent, or you are connected somehow, when we talk about African descent, we are talking about people who come out from Africa,
yeah,
or you have African blood running in your genes. That means maybe your father is an African, your mother is from another place. Is that?
Yeah, well, I think it was Peter Tosh who did a reggae. I think it was like 20 years ago. He said, if you're a black man or a black woman,
yeah,
you're an African.
Exactly. There are some people who don't even, you know, I was somewhere with a Moroccan. Can you imagine?
Yeah.
And then he was telling me, you Africans. I said, where are you from?
Morocco is in Africa. Morocco is a part of Africa. But they, apparently, okay, it's another story.
No, sometimes
they don't see themselves.
Yeah, exactly.
But that's colorism, we call it. It's colorism. They think that, well, they say them, that they're Arabs. But anyway, we shouldn't have this conversation right now.
Yeah, exactly.
Another time we have this conversation about the Moroccans. But the thing is, African descent is African descent.
Exactly.
I mean, they're talking about continental
of
Africans,
Africa, yes,
and also the African American,
African Americans,
the Afro Surinamese,
yes,
Afro Antillean,
yes,
the Afro Trinidadian, the Afro Jamaican,
yes,
they're all part Africans of the African descent.
Yes,
the Afro Brazilian, Colombian, Venezuelan,
yes,
they're all
African descent.
Yeah,
yes, exactly.
Definitely.
Exactly. So or Trinidad and Tobago.
Trinidad and Tobago, all Jamaica,
of that.
All
yes,
of that.
Yeah.
It's all part of this African descent. Whether it's in the Netherlands or in France or Germany or
anyway,
the UK, mm-hmm, or whatever.
Yeah.
And that's the whole thing, the African descent, people of African descent.
So
it's to make a change into this whole thing, that when you see people of African descent, wherever you see them, they shouldn't be at the bottom of the heap.
Exactly. Enough is enough.
Definitely.
Well, because we have talent. We are
gifted.
Oh,
definitely.
So we have to be where we're supposed to be.
Oh, definitely. And that's part of it.
I support this movement.
That's part of this whole recognition. Recognition,
yes,
and development.
Development.
And equality. That's part of it. Yeah.
It is awesome.
Yeah.
So if you have listened to us and you feel like making contact with Dr. Atwell, please just give him a call on
06-2323-7969.
67. Yeah. Okay? Yeah. So I repeat, 06-2323-7967.
Right.
And then please give him a call and tell him that you are of African descent. Otherwise, on the screen, you can also see the same contact address of Dr. Atwell. And fill that form. Please do everything to fill that form if you are an African organization. So thank you for...
And send it to us as quickly as possible, because we need to have it before, by Tuesday, by before Wednesday.
Oh, really?
Yeah, definitely.
It's too quick.
It's too quick, but then, well, if we don't do it, they say, okay, we asked them, but they never did it. Because
we will do it. Even though we're going to fill our own tonight.
Oh, great. Thanks. Right. Thanks. Yeah. Thanks. Thanks.
So thank you, Doctor, for being with
us.
Yes.
Thank you for inviting me.